Episode 4, A New Hope, or as it's also known, Star Wars. The first ever Star Wars movie came out in 1977. This was your grandparents' Star Wars. This, you know, the people that were born in the 40s and 50s, this was their thing. This was Star Wars, and it was the beginning of a new era. All I know is I've been a fan of Star Wars my entire life, or as much of it that I can remember. I'm always afraid to review Star Wars movies, especially the original saga, because I want to remain in the bliss that is Star Wars. There's nothing wrong with them and that they're amazing. They shall all be rated 100%. That's what I want to stay in the mindset of. However, I cannot stay there. Well, let's get into it. First up is the people category. We're looking at the acting, characters, casting, importance, and chemistry. All of which get perfect scores except for acting. You like their characters and everything, which is great, and they all work well together, and you can't imagine anybody else in the roles but these people because it's been so long. They all have their important roles to play, adding to the direction of the plot, but the only thing that you can't really notice is that there isn't much of an acting range from everybody. Everybody has these diverse, colorful characters that do different things and have different emotions, but each individual person kind of remains in their emotional state. So that gets half points, so people score gets 9 out of 10 possible stars. Next up, we're looking at the writing score, which goes over the dialogue, the balance of the film, the depth of the story, originality, and how interesting it is, all of which get perfect scores again, except for the balance of the film. The balance is okay, but it's not perfect, as every individual character has their own reason to be doing the things that they're doing in the movie. And it's not always going towards one goal. So instead of going straight for the Death Star, they go for Princess Leia, even though that's not what they're trying to do at first. They just kind of get sucked into it. It's fun to watch. It's great. It's just, it's not perfectly balanced. So that gets half points. Everything else is perfect. Some people complain about George Lucas's dialogue with the characters. I personally think it's great, specifically because you can't deny the fact that these are very memorable lines and quotes and just the way things are said. Yes, it's kind of cheesy sometimes, but it is memorable. People are still quoting this movie. The depth of the story goes a little bit beyond just the fact that this is a dark side and a light side, and this is evil and this is light, but it also has to do with why this is evil and why it's light and why you must do the right thing even when it seems hard to do. As for originality, it was 1977, and there was really nothing like it, maybe other than Star Trek, which was a TV show at the time. And it, of course, is interesting. It's the beginning of a new era in science fiction and space wars and things of the nature. So writing gets 9 out of 10 possible stars. Next up is the BTS score, which goes over the visuals, the directing, the editing, advertisement, and music and sound, all of which get perfect scores except for visuals. Normally, I would have probably given the visuals full points because the original theatrical version of this movie was all practical effects and it looked really good for the time that it existed. But when they created the specialized version, which is the only version that you can acquire now, you have George Lucas's edits with the special CGI characters and random things going on in the background, which don't help the movie as much as they distract the viewer when it comes down to things. Especially when you have big, gigantic creatures walking across the screen, obscuring your vision of what's actually happening behind it with the main characters. Because it has these distracting elements, I will have to give it only half points. Everything else is great. You may argue with me about George Lucas and how he directs things, but I think, especially for 1977, it's still very exciting and it is put together rather well, so the editing is all there. It is exactly as you would imagine it being. The advertising is perfect, and of course, it has one of the most recognizable and brilliant musical scores ever. BTS gets 9 out of 10 possible stars. Next up is the narrative arc score, and the narrative arc gets perfect points all around. The introduction got you acquainted with all the main players. The inciting incident is when Luke Skywalker agrees to go with Obi-Wan and start his training to be a Jedi while they're on their way to destroy the Death Star and all that fun stuff. The obstacles, obviously, it's a Star Wars movie, and there's lots of things going on, primarily speaking, a war that just never seems to stop. The climax, of course, cinematic climaxes in cinema history. The falling action does calm down, return to a new norm. 10 out of 10 for narrative arc. Entertainment score. How entertaining is it? This goes over how rewatchable it is, fun experience, your impulse to buy it, your impulse to talk about it, and if it sucks the audience in. All of which gets perfect points. This was an entertaining movie above all else, in my opinion. It is very rewatchable. I've watched it so many times, I don't have a number for you. Fun experience. You have fun while watching. You have a good time while watching. This is Star Wars. Impulse to buy it. Yes, the original trilogy. Each of those movies, I wouldn't mind buying on their own. Impulse to talk about it, this is one of those movies where it's like, you haven't seen Star Wars? What is wrong with you? How have you been living under a rock this whole time? You need to watch it. You need to watch this. You need to watch The Empire Strikes Back. You need to watch Return of the Jedi. You need to watch them all. And does it suck the audience in? I think so. I think there's so much stuff going on that it's hard not to focus on everything. Because it is a very classic sci-fi movie. So entertainment gets 10 out of 10 possible stars. So with the specialty category, I want to know how it fits as a Star Wars movie. Of course, it's the first Star Wars movie. It's the one that defines what Star Wars is. So that gets 10 out of 10 possible stars. As an action film, as they are all action films, how is the action? The action is great. The action is constant. The action is thrilling. 10 out of 10 possible stars. As an adventure film, I gotta say, the adventure is mostly in space, but also different locations throughout the movie, which keeps things going, keeps things exciting. 10 out of 10 possible stars. Now, as you can probably only watch the specialty edition, how much does that actually help the movie, and how much does it actually hurt the movie? Because I do believe it does a little bit of both. There are some benefits of it. If you're looking at the series as a whole, there's now more movies with CGI than there is without it. So the use of CGI definitely helps the original trilogy feel like it fits with all the other movies. It hurts the movie when it comes down to doing a little bit too much CGI and having things cross in front of the screen, as well as random things like stormtroopers riding those big animals, which I don't understand why. So that gets half points. 5 out of 10 possible stars. Is it halfway decent, or in terms of does it still hold up to today standards? I think so. So that gets 10 out of 10 possible stars. If we add up all the points, we get 92 out of 100 possible stars. 92%, which of course is pretty good. Not perfect, but it's in the 90s, so that's pretty good. Guys, tell me what you thought of Star Wars, A New Hope in the comments down below. As for YouTube, you know you can subscribe to me, hit that like button, and hit that bell to be notified when I come out with my next review, which should be tomorrow. So stick around for that, and until then, peace out.